Many travelers only know it from the Madagascar movies, and few travelers visit. Madagascar is the fourth largest island in the world. Although much about it is unknown, it's been the subject of several documentaries and films, and is one of the world's most unique places. If you want to plan your next trip to Africa, please visit flightstoafrica.net to grab the best flight deals to Africa. Here are the 10 best places to visit in Madagascar in 2022. Number 10, Ifaty. It is the name given to a pair of resorts that are located on the southwestern coast of the island of Madagascar. These villages were originally established as fishing communities. They bring in some of the most people in the country, since they are famous for their opulent hotel resorts and their expansive beaches that are covered in bright yellow sand. Others head in to enjoy catamaran tours on the Mozambique Channel, sample the uber fresh fish curries, and encounter the traditional reed villages of the coastal folk. The majority of visitors come for the rigmarole of sun, sea, and sand, as well as world-class snorkeling that is offered by the Indian Ocean. Number 9. Nosy Be. Gorgeous little Nosy Be is the spot to go for Madagascar's signature beaches. It is located just a little distant away from the town of Ambanja, which is located on the other side of the waters of the Indian Ocean. They crop up attractively around little fishing settlements like Ambotaloka, or appear lined with clusters of swaying palms at Ambondora, and shine with hues of alabaster, white in the bays and inlets that ring the beach here. In addition to this, there are beaches parties that take place along the dunes of Madirokli every Sunday. In addition, despite the popularity of Nosy Be, there are opportunities to enjoy genuine privacy on the island. One need only travel to the remote island of Orangia, which is located some distance from the northwest coast of the island. Number 8. Nosy Mangabe. Nosy Mangabe, a small island that is also a nature reserve, can be found tucked away in the depths of the coastal hills of Helodrona, Antongila Bay, which carves its way inland on the northeastern edge of Madagascar. This location makes Nosy Mangabe an absolute necessity for any nature lovers who will be traveling to this region. The location is re-owned for the thriving populations of bug-eyed eye-eye lemurs, and is a picture-perfect example of a tropical paradise. Ruffed lemurs and mantella frogs meet in the forest, and the green hills crash down into isolated coves of bright golden sand. Huge fig trees tangle with palm groves as they grow in close proximity to one another. The nearest town on the mainland to the island, Maruntirsta, has both boats to take visitors to the island, as well as all of the necessary permissions. Number 7. Tsingy di Bemaraha. The Tsingy di Bemaraha is one of the most intriguing natural gems of the Madagascar that has to offer. It is a truly stunning environment consisting of sculpted rocks and towering hoodoos, needle-like stone spires, and huge monoliths sitting precariously atop cliffs. It may be situated in the middle of a long green belt of natural reserves on the west coast, showcasing its rough karst landscapes at the point where the highlands of the interior give way to the verdant hills that are closest to the beaches. The dry deciduous forests, unusual rock habitats, and the signs character of the sweeping plateau within it all contributed to its designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in the modern day. Number 6. Ranomafana National Park. Ranomafana National Park is not only the growing natural attraction of Fianrasto, but it is also only known habitats of the world's famous golden bamboo lemur. As a result, the park welcomes tens of thousands of visitors annually to its forested reaches in the island's central eastern region. The terrain is crisscrossed with hiking trails that stretch for miles and miles, is craved out by roaring waterfalls, and is covered in multicolored lizards. It descends from foggy highland forests to lowland plains. The highlights of Ranomafana are hidden deep into regions, mountains, and forests. Therefore, you should be sure to have sturdy footwear and strong legs for your adventure. Number 5. Isalo National Park. After just a short journey out of either Toliara or Ihozi, you may arrive at the stunning Isalo National Park, which is comprised of a patchwork of carved rock gorges and twisting canyons, flowering oases, and palm groves. This park is truly a sight to behold. This one has been designated as a protected area as far back as 1962, and it's exceptionally high biodiversity and one-of-a-kind natural composition are immediately noticeable. People travel here to be awestruck by the uniformed mountains that are washed by the wind and to wander beneath the towers of stacked stone. They travel all the way there to catch a glimpse of the endangered crested ibis and the ring-tailed lemurs in their natural habitat. In addition, there are more than 80 different endemic bird species to look out for, as well as the well-known canyon of monkeys, which is home to a population of dexterous sifakas. Number 4. Antananarivo. Antananarivo, the nation's capital, is located more than 1,400 meters above the sea level in the very highland center of the country. Because of this location, this city is frequently brushed with brisk mountain breezes throughout the majority of the year. However, those breezes may be the only thing that is pleasant about the cityscape, which is otherwise alive with the sound of honking vehicles and yelling merchants. Elegant, albeit weather, Parisian homes cascade down a hillside in the middle of the city in the historic district of the city, which still has some remnants of the French colonial era. This district is known as the old heart of the city. In addition, there are historical Malagasy places to investigate, as well as the world famous crocodile farm and plethora of curry currants that smell of exotic spices. Number 3. Andanasib Mantadia is one of the most accessible national parks in Madagascar because it is located within driving distance of the country's capital and is therefore ideal for day trips. It encompasses a tremendous expanse that extends over more than 150 square kilometers in total and is covered in a wide tract of beautiful unspoiled jungle. A staggering variety of flora and fauna can be seen throughout the entire region, which is comprised of two distinct areas, the expansive Dimantedia Reserve and the Anzala Mazorota Special Reserve. There are even fluffy injury monkeys, diadmant sifakas that swing between the trees, and inland crabs that creep through the forest floor. And Mantadia is home to a plethora of hiking trails, with options for outings lasting anything from 1 to 6 hours. Number 2. Ambohi Manga. It is a location that is intricately intertwined with the national identity of Madagascar. It is also known by the name Royal Hill, and in the past it served as the residence of the regional rulers. The mound of palaces and buried grounds, crumbling fortifications and royal tombs was the kingpin of one of Madagascar's four quadrants, and the place from which King launched his famous campaigns to reunify Imerina following more than seven decades of civil war in the 18th century. The mound was expanded and added to throughout the 1800s. Today, tourists may take a day excursion from the nation's capital to visit the UNESCO monument and tour it, taking in the royal courtrooms and the gorgeous timber and stone rova architecture along the way. Number 1. Zahamina National Park. The famed jewel of the Astanishana rainforests may be found in the shape of Zahamina National Park. It is shrouded in rain clouds and mist, covered in rolling canopies of emerald green, and concealed between the rising peaks on the eastern side of Madagascar. This area of just 400 square kilometers is home to one of the most diverse collections of avian life, and is also one of the protected zones in the country that is among the most difficult to access. Indeed, crimson owls and serpent eagles soar through the waxy boughs and fern forests, where they come across white-eyed indris, dwarf lemurs, and other interesting species of simian life. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.